Find out how to install Lubuntu in VirtualBox. So let's get started. First, go to Lubuntu's official website and click on the downloads link. Lubuntu is available in two different distributions. The distribution of 23.10, Mantic Minotaur, support will continue until July 2024. For most users, the recommended distribution is 22.04.4 LTS, Jammy Jellyfish. So I'm going to download the 22.04.4 LTS version. Click the desktop 64-bit button to start downloading, and it will save the file to the downloaded directory. As you can see, I've already installed VirtualBox on my PC. For details, check out my VirtualBox installation guide video. The video link's description is below, and the information card is at the top. Hence, simply choose New. In the name field, enter Lubuntu. The folder that appears here will hold your preferred virtual machine. You can keep it set to the default, but I'll move it to another folder. Regarding the ISO image, go to the file locations folder and select the ISO image file. Then click on Next. On this screen, we can specify the hardware for the virtual machine. You can specify how much RAM the virtual machine should get, as well as the number of processors. For now, I'll go with 3 GB for the memory, and for the processors, let's go with 3. Down below, I'll click on Next. On this screen, you can decide how much hard disk space you want to use for your virtual machine. The default is 25 GB. I will change it 50 GB, and then click Next. We now see a summary of all of our different selections. Down below, let's click on Finish. After creating a Lubuntu virtual machine, click on Settings. From General Settings, select the Advanced tab. In the Share Clipboard and drag and drop down menu, select Bidirectional. Description and Encryption tab, you can keep the default setting. In the System Settings, select the Motherboard tab. Uncheck the floopy checkbox in boot order. I set the base memory to 3 GB. You can change it here. In the Extended Features, keep it unaltered. In the Processor tab, ensure the CPU is not less than 2. The execution cap is 100%. Enable PAE/NX is checked. It will enhance the processor performance of the virtual machine. On Acceleration tab, keep the default setting. In the Display Settings, select the Screen tab. Video memory increases to 128 MB for a good display. Remote Display and Recording Settings, keep default. In the Storage Settings, keep default settings. Allow all audio, network, serial settings to stay unaltered. USB set to version 3.0. Shared folders and user interface settings, keep them default. Click OK. Now start the virtual machine. After Lubuntu boot completes, the Lubuntu desktop screen will appear. Here is the Lubuntu desktop screen. Click the Install Lubuntu 22.04.4 LTS icon. The Lubuntu installer window will appear on the screen. I'll stick with American English as my default language. Choose the language that best suits you. My location will remain default. You can choose based on your country's location. I keep the default keyboard layout. You can change it to your liking. Partitions have two options: erase disk and manual partitioning. The erase disk option partitions the disk automatically. This partition will be assigned to the hard disk you specified for the virtual machine. I'll select to erase the disk. Keep it swapped to the file. Click the Next. Fill up the user section with your username, computer name, and login password. You can keep the checkbox for automatic login without a password, but I'll uncheck it. Click the Next. We now have a summary of all of our locations, keyboards, and partition details. After reviewing everything, click the Install button and select Install Now. Installing the configuration files will take some time. When the installation is finished, it will display the Restart Now option. Now click Done. After restarting, the screen says, please remove the installation medium, then press Enter. To remove the installation media, go to the Device menu, choose Optical Drive, and then remove the disk from the virtual drive. If it freezes, like mine, that means it has already been removed. Otherwise, you can remove it from here. After that, make sure you press the Enter keys on the keyboard. On the login screen, type the password and hit Enter. Finally, the Lubuntu 22.04.4 operating system has been installed in VirtualBox. The display screen and the virtual machine screen sizes are not the same. We're going to use the View menu virtual screen option to adjust the screen size, but it's locked, and we can't select a resolution. To resolve this, I'll open the update notification window and apply all of the system updates. It'll ask for a password. Enter your password. After completing the upgrade, reboot the system and select Yes. After booting, enter your login password. Now, from System Tools, open the Q Terminal. On the terminal, type Write the sudo su command to log in as the root user, then enter the password. By writing the cd command, it will take to the root directory. Using the sudo apt-get upgrade command, you can upgrade the system at the terminal. I had already upgraded the system, so there were no additional upgrades. Run the sudo apt-get upgrade command in the terminal. It will update all software packages. The sudo apt install linux headers $unamr build essential dkms command in the terminal. Yes, it will install the necessary packages. Navigate to the devices menu and click insert guest edition cd image. Click OK. Then, from the top tools option, select open in terminal. Run the sudo su command, then input the password. Use the ls command to list all files. Here, the vboxlinuxedition.run file needs to be executed and run. By entering sudo chmod plus x vboxlinuxeditions.ru, command file permissions will be changed to sudo slash vboxlinuxeditions.run command to install VirtualBox guest editions. Run the sudo reboot command to reboot the system. After rebooting, enter your password and log in. Now, click on the view menu virtual screen to resize your screen resolution. Anytime you want a different display, you can adjust the size of your screen. Select auto resize guest display, which will automatically adjust the virtual screen display to match your host display screen. For full screen, go to view, select full screen mode, and it will be full screen. You may undo full screen by going to the bottom menu, selecting view, and clicking full screen. It will be set back to the display screen. This concludes the video. If you like this video, subscribe, like, turn on notifications, and share it.